Hi there, this is Richard Walker from Lucidate. Welcome back to our series on building a FinBot using AI and the LangChain framework. In our previous video, we explored the fundamentals of interacting with a chat language model and discussed how a chat LM differs from regular large language models. We emphasized the importance of maintaining context in a conversation, recording the human's input, the AI's response, and so on. This context is important for generating future responses. But let's face it, when it comes to finance, AI and large language models have a couple of limitations that we must overcome. Firstly, it's 2023 now, and most leading AI systems were trained on data only up to 2021. That means their knowledge is wholly outdated for the fast-paced world of finance, where up to the second information is crucial. And secondly, while AI excels in language processing, it struggles when it comes to presenting complex charts and graphics. Lucidate believes that the future of AI in capital markets lies in harnessing the power of multiple specialized large language models that communicate and collaborate with one another to achieve a common goal, mimicking the behavior of humans in assembling teams of specialists, marketers to promote products and create brand awareness, salespeople to identify customers, build relationships, and negotiate contracts, product managers to oversee the development of products and collaborate with cross-functional teams, finance professionals to manage budgets and conduct financial analysis, as well as legal, compliance, accounting, and operations. High-performing business teams are made up of diverse professionals with complementary skills. So it is with AI. We'll illustrate this in today's video with a simple architecture that uses three specialist AI large language models. The first will be a chat LM that will be responsible for questioning the user to get a picture of that user, including their investment goals, investment horizon, risk tolerance, and investment experience. The second AI will be a regular large language model that will analyze the interaction between the user and the chat AI and determine if real-time information needs to be sourced from the market and if the pure text answer from the chat AI would be better if it was accompanied by tables, graphs, or charts. To accomplish this, this LLM will make use of the tree of thoughts and chain of thought prompting techniques that we've explored in prior videos. Finally, a third chat LLM will specialize in providing concrete investment advice, given the details of the investor's risk profile and their existing portfolio. Later in this video, I'll explain how you can get access to the source code for this demo application that you can use as a foundation for your own multi-model AI experiments. I'll also explain how you can get access to a code walkthrough of this demo application. A key component of all of this orchestrated ensemble behavior is prompt engineering. I'll share the prompts that I've found to be successful in this architecture, but my experience suggests that experimenting with these prompts is key to yield better and better performance. Use the prompts here as a starting point. They work, but experiment with major or subtle changes in prompt language to observe different outcomes. As ever, LangChain makes it easy to experiment with a whole range of prompts and prompt techniques. Here's the prompt augmentation that I've used for the first chat LLM. This is the prompt that steers the AI towards learning a lot about the investor. There's nothing in here about any portfolio, the market, or any asset class or investment. This prompt helps the first AI build up a picture of the investor to provide a foundation for the advice to follow. Next, let's look at the prompts for the LLM that will assess if further real-time information needs to be sourced from the market, and if any graphics or tables would help illustrate the text response from the chat LM. In this demo, I've used both chain of thoughts prompts, as well as prompts inspired by the tree of thoughts approach. There's a link in the description for videos that explain these techniques. I found that both work equally well in this scenario. I perhaps lean slightly towards the simpler chain of thought prompt in this case, but as ever, I encourage you to experiment with your own prompts. Now, let's walk through a demo to see these concepts in action. The initial chat LLM engages the user, asking questions about their risk appetite, time horizon, and investment goals. The user initially provides their name, and the AI prompts for further information, consistent with the prompt template that you saw a few moments ago. You can see here the evidence of the chat language model in action, where the name of the user is set, and the AI uses this context in subsequent questions. The user indicates that they're saving for retirement, as well as some details about their financial circumstances. This prompts FinBot to dig deeper into Richard's situation and asks how much they're looking to invest a month. Richard gives some time frame information, as well as a figure for monthly investment. Again, consistent with the prompt, the AI wants to get an assessment of the user's risk appetite on a range of 1 to 10. Let's stretch the AI just a little bit and see what it makes of a decimal answer. FinBot has now been able to gather quite a bit of information, and the next response summarizes the situation and provides some high-level advice. It's now probing for even more detail. The user asks about a specific stock. Now, the AI has built up enough of a picture about Richard to be able to offer some reasoned advice, but it's keen to contextualize the answer based on diversification and further knowledge on existing holdings. In response to that, Richard indicates that he's recently inherited a portfolio of stock from an uncle. The AI requests that Richard provide some information on the portfolio and instructs him to drag and drop the portfolio into the drop zone on the sidebar on the left. While it's by no means essential to do so, I've found that this is an excellent opportunity to now draft in a second chat language model. While the first was specialized at teasing out information from the user, this model is now focused on providing investment advice, given the context of the portfolio. The prompt that I've used for this second chat language model is shown on the screen. As the conversation progresses, the graphing and charting large language model recognizes the opportunity to present the inherited portfolio in a table format. This showcases the portfolio's composition and holdings in a clear and concise manner. The user expresses curiosity about the diversification of their portfolio. Now again, here's where the second chat language model, working in conjunction with the graphing large language model, shines. It generates a starburst chart that compares the sector, subsector, and stock composition of the S&P 500 with the user's portfolio. This visual representation offers valuable insights into the diversification and sector exposure of the portfolio. This type of starburst chart affords much more interactivity than just the text conversation. The user is able to click on chart sectors to drill down into the portfolio composition. The largest sector in the S&P by market cap is information technology. Richard can see the makeup of this S&P sector and even drill down into the semiconductor subsection, which contains Nvidia, the stock he was curious about earlier. The same colors are used in the S&P chart as well as the starburst of Richard's portfolio. He can use this information to easily see that he's underweight technology and semiconductors relative to the S&P. Thus, an investment in Nvidia may well be appropriate to rebalance his portfolio. The largest sector in Richard's portfolio is consumer discretionary, which includes Nike, Tesla, and Ross stores. He's overweight this sector relative to the S&P, which may have served him well historically, but with 2023's persistent high inflation, he may want to reduce his exposure to this particular sector. the constraints of the chat window make the charts perhaps a little difficult to see and properly interact with. There is a little expand toggle in the upper right, which Richard can use to make the chart larger. While this temporarily loses the context of the chat and advice, it does make drilling down into both the S&P constituents as well as the stocks in his own portfolio easier to manage. Perhaps thinking that Tesla has delivered stellar returns historically, but might be a stock to sell to reduce the exposure to consumer discretionary, he asks to see a chart of Tesla prices. The charting LLM is able to oblige with an OCHL, open, close, high, low chart for this stock. Once again, this is an interactive chart as part of the chat, and Richard can zoom in and out to see that the stock has been on the rise since January 2023 after having lost about two-thirds of its value between August 2022 and January the following year. Thinking perhaps of selling Tesla and buying Nvidia, Richard asked to see the fundamentals and key ratios of Nvidia to determine if it's a sound buy at these levels. Again, the charting LLM makes a determination that a table of key fundamentals is a helpful addition at this stage and renders this in the chat window. To wrap up the video, I'd like to emphasize the significance of these advancements by combining several specialized chat LLMs with a regular LLM. We bridge the gap between up-to-date information and language capabilities, empowering our ensemble FinBot to provide more accurate and insightful financial advice. This simple, but I hope effective application shows Lucidate's view of the future, multiple specialist LLMs working together as an effective ensemble, much as humans do in business. It also shows the future of some AI applications. When using natural language as an interface, it's easy to delegate the choice of reports to an LLM. Rather than only having hard-coded reports in an application, the LLM can make decisions about what database and object queries might be necessary to provide bespoke reports for users on the fly. Frequently accessed reports can still be provided and accessed with the usual user interface controls of menu items and drop-down lists, but allowing users to request custom reports using natural language may be extremely useful in times of stress. Imagine during the US debt ceiling crisis of Q2 2023, if you could ask how many counterparties have more than 30% of their collateral in short-dated US treasuries. Or going back to Q3 2008, how much exposure do we have to Lehman Brothers Prime Brokerage? Full disclosure, I was employed by Lehman Brothers Prime Brokerage in 2008, and then all of a sudden, I wasn't. Lucidate's members at particular levels have access to the source code of this application as well as a code walkthrough video. You can join Lucidate's membership program by using the desktop browser-based version of YouTube and hitting the join button on the lower left below the video. Lucidate has several tiers of membership, each with its own perks and privileges. At Lucidate's VP level, you can get early access to Lucidate's videos before they're put on general release. At this VP level, you also get access to Lucidate's Discord server. From this server, you can request to be added to the GitHub repo that houses this source code. Lucidate VPs and above can download this simple app and make it their own. Use it as is, but more importantly, make improvements to it to add additional functionality. Members at the MD level can enjoy a video that does a code walkthrough of this demo application. In conclusion, today's video has highlighted the enhancements we've made to our FinBot architecture using LangChain and AI. We've demonstrated how the integration of a regular large language model and specialized chat language models overcomes the limitations of outdated information and challenges that AI has with visual representations. Our demo showcased the interactive and dynamic nature of the FinBot, providing personalized portfolio analysis and advice. Stay tuned for our next video, where we will use LangChain agents and the React prompting technique to enhance the text responses of FinBot to include up-to-date information from company financials. Don't miss this opportunity to explore the potential of AI in the financial domain. Thank you for joining us today, and we look forward to seeing you in the next video.